We pay your guys' wage. We voted for you. We can vote you out.
Amen.
Unfortunately, after several warnings from the board chair.
We can stop this meeting. I've already asked you folks.
People got a little out of hand and were cheering from the audience, and we're not respecting the order of the school board meeting. And so because there was not order and because we could not maintain order, we did have to end the school board meeting tonight.
All right, meeting has been adjourned.
We are the people!
The Caldwell School Board and the Caldwell School District believe in democracy, and we believe in communicating respectfully. And unfortunately, tonight reached a place where people were not communicating respectfully.
Okay, so that was just a sample of what happened last night in the Caldwell School District monthly Board of Trustees meeting. That is to say, a sample of the acrimony on display when hundreds showed up to express their opinion of a policy that was on the proposed policy section of the agenda. This is where items live when they're just in the consideration phase, the discussion phase. It's a place where this policy has been percolating for months, just gathering input from the Caldwell School District patrons, like students, parents, taxpayers. It addresses gender identity and sexual orientation within the district. A couple of changes have to do with the use of school facilities like locker rooms and bathrooms, or even overnight school trips, based on the gender identity they express at school. There's also a section in there that deals with confidentiality that says when contacting the parent, guardian of a transgender student, school personnel should use the student's legal name and the pronoun corresponding to the student's gender assigned at birth unless determined by a previously developed plan. And a lot of those there to protest the policy last night, they see this part as a deception on the part of the school personnel, the sort of hiding of a secret life if a student feels safe enough to be who they are at school among friends but not at home. And if you're wondering what that might feel like for someone to not feel safe about who they are when it comes to sexual and gender orientation, here's how one of the hundreds lined up outside who couldn't get in the room summed up why they were there.
Gender affirming would mean affirming their gender, when in fact it's affirming their confusion. And so anything that affirms the confusion of a child, we are against. We want to preserve the children, the innocence and the integrity, and those who are confused, our heart is to help them and bring them back to a healthy mindset.
That is a pastor from a church in Star. The Board of Trustees vice chair told us last night the reason this policy 3281 is being considered is this district was having issues at the secondary schools with how to deal with the LGBTQ plus community. And they decided to take a look at the recommendations of their policy committee, and they wanted to be transparent about it. So a lot of people decided to show up last night to express their concerns. So many, they were lined up outside to get in and speak, but they couldn't. No room in the boardroom, and public testimony was limited to just 1 hour. Well, they didn't even get to that point. They didn't even last an hour, because about 40 minutes into that testimony, it was State Senator Chris Traikle's turn at the podium. Senator Traikle from Caldwell, who was just at the State House earlier Monday for the first day of his first legislative session, decided to attend last night's Board of Trustees meeting. Senator Traikle says he has kids in the school district, but last night he wasn't there as a parent. He was there in his official position as a state senator.
You, under Idaho law, are required to maintain the morals and health of all the students. How can you do that when, like that little girl came up here and said, and you allow a male to use a female bathroom? You're going to put all of their moral health and safety at risk. And like I told you before, you will face litigation. So before you waste taxpayer money, before you put a kid in harm's way, you better throw this policy out and not even consider. I've got the floor. Ms. Pacino, will you please listen to me?
Sir.
Yeah, you claim you want people to follow the rules, but you break the rules left and right. Last month, you allowed two people
all
to
right,
speak.
We will recess this meeting right now. I'm sorry. We have asked you absolutely know the protocol.
You're not following protocol yourself.
Madam Chair, I move to adjourn.
Okay, I have a motion to adjourn. Do I have a second?
No.
A second.
Okay, we have a second.
Real fast, I'm going to quote section 74201. The people of the state of Idaho and creating the instruments of their government. Sir, do not yield the sovereignty to the agency so
called vote.
This is who you listen to.
Okay, can you turn him off? Okay, so I would like to call vote. All those in favor, please say aye.
Aye.
Okay, all right, meeting has been adjourned. Meeting is adjourned.
As you heard earlier, people stood up and yelled cowards at the Board of Trustees. And that wasn't the first time, by the way, Senator Tracol has spoken at a Caldwell School Board meeting. Back in December, you heard him reference that a month ago. He was there to protest the same policy and claimed transgender youth only represents, well, less than 1% of the population. So why do they want to create a policy to, in his words, bend to the minority? Quote, the majority in our country does not bend to the minority. It's never been that way. End quote. That was from then-Senator-elect Chris Tracol on December 12, 2022. We tried to reach out to Senator Tracol today to ask him about how that logic about bending to a minority might apply to the civil rights movement in the 1960s when segregationists routinely used the Bible and religious freedom to oppose racial equality. We even stopped by the State House today, but he refused to speak with us. We did, however, get a chance to ask the Caldwell School Board Chair, Maricela Pessina, who wanted to explain why she felt the need to end the meeting last night. She's been a school board member for the past 7 years, three as the board chair. She sent us a statement that says, in part, first and foremost, community engagement and civil discourse is a part of policymaking. As an elected school board member for almost 7 years, I get it. I appreciate the dialogue. The crux of this process, though, is the word civil. My job as the chair is not only to make progress on the agenda, but to ensure the order of the meeting. I'll let her take it from there.
So here's the deal. Our children are watching us. The adults and leaders, and they're watching us to learn how to engage in our community process. Our children were watching us last night, all of us. They were watching the board, they were watching the audience, they were watching the speakers. In Idaho, one of the greatest things that we appreciate and expect local control, and school board will be as local as it gets. That's as far down as it gets, local control. And so the passion of our community on display wasn't lost on me. And yet we still have work to do. We want to hear from Caldwell School District constituents, including the brave youth who stood up and spoke to us last night. And so to those kids, I am extremely proud of you. You are why we are here and why we, as school board members, volunteers give back to our community. So that's my statement.
Ultimately, what is this about, this policy?
We're just trying to make sure our children have a safe environment and to make sure our children are treated with dignity. It's the bottom line.
Have you ever been involved in anything like this scenario before?
Like what happened last night in the meeting?
Yes.
It was never like this. It wasn't, this was more of a mob mentality kind of thing, you know? And so it was scary. This is the first time that I had, it was intimidating. I was scared for the safety of my board and some of the students that were here.
Were you surprised by the turnout?
Yes, very much so. What I was more surprised is that many of these people that were here were not Caldwell School District patrons. They were from out of town.
So the number of people that were there surprised you. What about the tone?
I figured that that's the way it was going to be, but, you know, Brian, I wish that we, more of our meetings had more people that were, that could come and speak and, you know, what, because, you know, we are not elected officials elected by our constituents. And we represent them. So we want to hear what they have to say.
Just not to that volume?
Probably, you know, I don't mind the volume. It's just the temperament and the hostility and aggressiveness. I think it was uncalled for and does not define civil discourse.
Okay, so that was not an action item last night, just a consideration policy, and so they're going to continue to consider it and maybe get to it, or maybe not, in future meetings. So this policy, though, the gender identity and sexual orientation, isn't exactly new. It's just new to Caldwell, as Board Chair Pacina told us. Probably the reason their attempt to adopt it is getting so much attention is because they're trying to be transparent about it. So this would be a good time to bring in Andrew Bartline, who decided to dig a little deeper into this proposal and see where else a similar policy might already be in place. And you reached out to several school districts around the state.
Yeah, and you said it's not new, and it certainly isn't new, and it's also not new in terms of where we might find it elsewhere in other school districts, because this does exist in other school districts. We reached out to a few of them and a couple different organizations. So here's, it's called 3281 to be exact. That's the name of the policy. And you can find this similar policy that Caldwell talked about almost word for word in other Idaho school districts. That includes Bonneville County, Teton County, and a similar policy we found in Blaine County as well. For the sake of breaking it down, we'll focus on 3281. Here's the scope right now. It boils down to a couple bullet points. A student can use a bathroom, locker room, or facility that reflects their own gender identity. School activities and sports just follows IHSAA guidelines. Nothing changes there. Accommodations are made for overnight school trips. Official school documentation reflects their legal name. Students must follow dress code. Same-sex couples will not be treated differently at school or school dances. And staff is to call students by their preferred name and pronouns at school, but staff will use the legal name and sex when speaking with parents unless previously determined otherwise. The policy outlined in this document garnered a large response, as Brian has touched on earlier.
How is the majority of the girls in the restroom or the locker room, how are they going to feel? Are they going to feel like they're in a safe environment when they encounter someone exposing themselves that does not look like a girl?
So this is a government-sponsored religion that is being imposed in the classroom. Even if it's not said directly to my son, if it is said in his presence, you are teaching him something that is the opposite of my family's religious beliefs.
It really bothers me that here they can come up with all this junk. We're to teach the children, period. Reading, writing, arithmetic, science, government. That's what you're supposed to be doing. We don't have time for this other foolishness.
Ironically, the government, a topic she says we ought to be teaching in school, does have time for this, quote, foolishness. And we know that because these gender identity policies cite Title IX in their footnotes. If you're not familiar, Title IX says it's against the law to discriminate based on sex in any education program that receives public dollars. The Idaho School Boards Association says lawyers are needed to write these type of policies. And we got in touch with the Blaine County School District, who has had an extremely similar policy since 2016. It's not the same language, but it touches on pretty much every bullet point. Their superintendent, Jim Foudy, told me over the phone that their district has had no problems at all since 2016 with their policy. Like, not even a single one. He says the policy is in place to align with federal law, and the district has 3,400 kids. He says it's rare to have a student where this policy needs to be discussed, but it does happen, and when they go through this process, they've had zero reported instances of somebody abusing this policy, making others uncomfortable through that abuse of policy. And the Idaho School Boards Association tells us that they have seen zero reports of abuse of this policy themselves, as they have worked with school boards to set up a similar policy that they would like to implement. They just haven't seen that happen once.
It's amazing. Yeah, no problems at all since 2016. By the way, so hundreds showed up last night at the Caldwell School Board meeting to oppose this policy. The West Ada School District Board of Trustees held their meeting last night, too. On their agenda, a $2.3 million increase in their transportation budget to actually help kids get to school safely. And by the looks of the video, a handful of people showed up to that.